Today I'm going to show you how to get around limits that cell phone companies put up on mobile data. Sometimes they will go through and throttle you when you hit a certain amount of data even though you're on unlimited, or you may just have a certain amount of data you can hit before you're no longer to use anymore, and then you have to pay extra. So there is a way around it, and that's today's tutorial. Welcome everyone, I'm Kevin from Helpful Tutorials, and here we're going to go ahead and show you on the iPhone, though it is very similar on the Android. It's just you would use Google Play instead of the App Store. You would click on it, and here you would type VPN. What VPN is it stands for Virtual Private Network. It makes it so it's harder for anyone to track where you are. They won't know it's you, they'll know it's where you're connected instead. So this helps get around a lot of things, especially if your area doesn't support something. For example, if a website is banned in your country, you could always go to a VPN and say you're from another country, and then you'll be able to go to that website. I know it's a little confusing, so I'm going to kind of show you how to get it connected. On the app stores, you go and search for VPN, but be very careful because there's a lot of different VPNs out there and some are a little not so secure and could be taking some of your data and your information. So you want to make sure you research which ones you'd want to go with. There are a lot of free VPNs. So just going through here and searching through, you can see that there is a lot of VPNs. It'll just keep going and going. So I've done some research and a lot of the VPNs, like I said, are a little rough. NordVPN, I heard good things about that one. But the one I decided to go with after everything said and done was ProtonVPN. So if you just go in the top and type ProtonVPN and search, you'll be able to get it here. You'll still get your ad first, but that'll come up here. So you can go ahead and download that if this is the one you choose. If not, like I said, find what works for you. This is not a sponsored video in any way. This is just the one that I've been using so far, and it seems to work pretty well. And it's rated pretty good out there. Once you have it on your phone, all you have to do is go ahead and click open. It'll open and it'll say not connected in countries. If you're just using this to get around the throttle, for example, if you've went over your data, say you're at unlimited and you're over say 25 gigabytes of data and your network slows you down, which they do, especially AT&T and Verizon, what you want to do is stay in your country and just pick a place near you. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the bottom because I'm in the United States. We're going to choose United States, and then you can go ahead and choose any of the plus servers for the first week. After that, they do become locked and you do need to choose a free server. The free server is gonna have a little more load, so you wanna go with the one that's lower, and there could also be ads displaying. Let's go ahead and connect here. It's gonna connect. And we are connected. So we are good to go. There's not gonna be as many servers to connect from if you are using the free service, but this worked good for me and continues to work well for me. Now, once you're connected, you're good and they won't be able to pick up your data. So the good thing to do at this point is if you are close to going over your data, go ahead and start using it so you never go over. Or if you go over and you start getting throttled, then turn it on. If you have a lot of data, then I wouldn't use it too much because it could possibly interfere with other things such as email. Certain websites may be a little odd, certain apps when you log in. So if you have any weird problems connecting to a certain app, then I would go in here and just disconnect. It's very simple. You just click disconnect at the bottom and you are disconnected. Just like that. So now I'm no longer connected, and now AT&T or Verizon can now see me again. I'm not some server in the US that's connecting to their data. Now I'm Kevin from Helpful Tutorials connecting, and they're aware of that. So now my data will start going up again. So this is how you go ahead and bypass throttling and getting more data than you're supposed to. I hope this helped. If you did, make sure to smack that like and go ahead and subscribe. Let me know what you'd like to know down below, and we will continue with the helpful tutorials.